There's one last thing that I want to talk about regarding a module, or specifically module 2, before you go ahead and jump right into the module. The way that the course is set up is that we as instructors are trusting that you as the student are taking your learning into your own hands, and that you are doing the reading that's being assigned, you are completing the knowledge test without just kind of guessing what the answer is and then submitting it a second time to get the ones right that you didn't get right the first time, and that you are most importantly completing all the skills-based activities in the book as you read. And the way that we've set it up is that instead of testing every single skill, we used to require students to do 150 skills-based activities a semester. We're trusting that you're doing those activities in the chapter, and if you're struggling with them, you're going to contact us or attend online office hours. And then at the end of the module, there's going to be a finishing up section. And so for module 2, that means you're going to complete chapters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and when you're done, you're going to complete a project and a module exam. Let's talk about the module exam first. The module exam is basically a summary of the chapters 1 through 6 that are in module 2. The questions are similar but not the same as the questions that you would see in the knowledge test. And if you want to study for the module exam before you take it, you can study the chapter tests that you took for chapters 1 through 6 for module 2. The module exam is more comprehensive than the knowledge test. The knowledge tests are all multiple choice. Every once in a while you might have a short answer question. The module exam is going to have multiple choice, true and false, fill in the blank. There's a lot of open-ended questions that say, why would you want to do blah, blah, blah? Or why would you choose this option over that option? Or of these two options, which one do you want to choose more? And a lot of them have no right or wrong answer. We're just looking for you to be able to process the information and take a stance on a point. So keep that in mind. In addition, the module exams will have practical skills-based application questions towards the end, usually the last 0 to 5 questions, because I think two of the exams don't have any of them, will be skills-based things you have to do. For example, when you learn Chapter 9 for selections, one of the questions will ask you to make and save a selection, and another one might say make and refine a selection of this hair. When you learn how to do layer masks, it'll say take these two images, create a hole in one with a layer mask so that you see through it to the next image, which may not make any sense to you right now, but that's okay. It will when we cover that in Chapter 9. Keep that in mind. The module exams you can only take one time as opposed to two, like you could do your knowledge test. And it's timed. You have 75 minutes for each module exam. Some of them should take 25 minutes, and so you have 75 minutes to get that done. But some of them you will need all 75 minutes. So you need to come prepared to take the exam. You'll need access to Photoshop while you're taking the test, and you need to make sure that you have that 75 minutes uninterrupted to take the exam, because once you start, your clock starts, and at 75 minutes, whether you're finished or not, the exam will submit. The second thing that you'll see at the end of a module are projects. There are 11 projects for this class. Module 1 has one project. If you scroll down to Module 3, it has two. Module 4, two projects. Module 5 and Module 6 both have three projects. And if you wait till the end of the module to start on these projects, it might feel a little bit overwhelming to get the activity done by the time it's due, right? So you wait until the 24th when you're finished Chapter 6, and then you have until the 27th to get your exam and your project done. For Module 2, it's not that big of a deal because it's something you can do in an hour or two sitting down. It's very skills-based. It's either right or wrong, and you'll see when you click on the project what the instructions will be for that. But for the other chapters, when you have more creative projects where you have to paint a picture or you have to create a travel postcard or something like that, you want to make sure that you're starting these activities early on in the module. So it's my recommendation that before you even start a module, so we're on Module 2 right now, after you read your learning objectives, don't start Chapter 1. Go down to the bottom of the module, click on the project and read through it and see what the expectations are. And then as you're completing chapters 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and whatever chapters you're working on for that particular module, as you come across something that's required in the project, make note of that. Put a star next to it. Put a big smiley face. Say, I'm going to need that. I'm going to need to reference that when I go to finish my project. And if it was me, I would work on the project side by side as I'm reading and completing those chapters. Okay, that's all I have for getting started with Module 2. So you can close out of these videos and you can get started. If you have any questions, by all means, email me either directly through Canvas or at the email address listed on your course syllabus. And as always, if I'm not your actual teacher but you're using my videos, make sure that you email your teacher if you have questions.